don't got the government shit yet. They still using it.
Yeah. We get their leftover.
Welcome back.
Who the fuck is going up an elevator, nigga?
To the motherfucking second annual 85 South Show Ghetto Awards.
This is the select straight.
Oh, we're not starting on practice. Pick your car. This is like the Soul Train. This is just a dry run.
You still need that time.
Dress rehearsal. I like how
y'all. Oh, this ain't it?
Yeah, I want the claps to be stronger on the real one. Stronger claps on the real one. Joe, what the fuck is you doing, man?
Waiting on the Davies?
You dressed like one of them niggas from Our Future now. Are you part of the internet? Chico, what's them you got on? This nigga here. I'm still wearing regular people's shoes. Yeah, but they could have been. They just missed their opportunity. Clay, you gotta stop wearing these regular people's shoes, man. Look at T-Pain. T-Pain got the motherfuckers Homer Simpson wanted. You know when Homer Simpson had them high dollar shoes and the dog ate them up. Them air assassins. My feet all regular size and shit. Y'all shoes got 3-4 levels and shit. We're a few minutes out. We'll give it 5 more minutes. We're trying to see if Beyonce gonna pull up. I mean, we always invite them, even if they don't come or not. They were invited. We invited Drake, the whole Young Money. Yeah. Didn't nobody hit us back but Lil Twist. Lil Twist was the only one that hit us back. Yeah. I lied to him. I told him it was tomorrow. I'm interrupting this program with some more breaking news. That's right. That's right. Return of the Ghetto Legends. We're going out west. January 7th. And guess where the show is? At the LA Forum. Yep, we're right there. I'm throwing up some powder like LeBron. It's going crazy. January 7th. Go to the website and get the tickets. Or go to the app. You don't got the app. You don't want to come to this show. But January 7th, we in L.A. Shit. Get the tickets. Me, Chico, D.C. Still ain't found me no new opener yet, though. Still ain't found me no new opener. Send me those clips. January 7th, Return of the Ghetto Legends. Merry Christmas. I get with you.
Perfect.
Y'all ready for this? It's that time of year again.
Let's do it.
And the people have been requesting.
Yes, of course.
Where the fuck is it now?
This has become annual at this point.
Oh, man.
It's shit.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer for a new generation.
Right.
In my mind, it's just as consistent as that.
Damn, so.
Everybody ready? J-O-N, you ready? Man, speaking to the mic and say something. The people ain't heard from you that much this year.
They still ain't heard that either, but it's
right.
Cool.
It's cool.
Your mic not on.
Chico, is it that time?
It is that time.
I'm gonna go ahead and say it then.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Welcome back to the 85 South Ooh. Show.
For the holiday.
For the holiday. And you know, by popular demand, we are doing our second annual 85 South Show. Yeah. This year's gonna be the Ghetto Legends edition of the 85 South Show Awards.
Yeah, yeah,
yes, indeed.
Yeah.
Man, we got our notes, we got categories from the fans, from online, from in the app. We got some things to do today.
Yeah, gotta celebrate another year of success.
Another one.
Continue. Hey, man, and they rocking with it everywhere, man. It's so big.
Man, what are they watching it at?
Oh, man, I told you New Zealand.
Already.
You saw that repost.
Right.
That was straight New Zealand. That's a Kiwi all day.
Okay, bet.
Yeah.
Nigga hit me from Czechoslovakia.
Nigga. Niggas came to see me from Iceland.
Come on.
Icelandic?
Yeah. Man, Icelandic motherfucker. Ooh. Nigga had a name longer than 285, but he was there.
As long as they come through Nova Scotia.
Nova Scotia?
Nova Scotia.
Man. Damn.
Yeah, I got at least 20 countries in Africa locked in.
Already?
Yeah.
South Africa for sure.
Hell yeah. We're trying to get the whole Africa.
Kenya.
The whole continent.
The whole continent.
Nigeria.
Yeah, fuck them up in Africa.
Right. Congo.
Tanzania.
Ivory Coast. Ooh. Tanzania.
Ghana.
Ethiopia, Eritrea.
Egypt.
Chad.
The Congo.
Come on, man.
The country, Cameroon.
Madagascar.
Ooh.
Damn.
I got dreams.
Worldwide. Let's go.
Well, let's just get right into it, man. You know, we're not always doing a live show.
Nope.
You know, there are other days in the week.
Yep.
And we spend a lot of those days right here in the trap.
In the trap.
In the trap doing numbers, first of all.
Yeah, first of all.
Hey, man.
I feel like the trap is the heart of the 85 South Show operation. I feel like that's really like our... like the dojo.
It's central.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's the headquarters.
Headquarters.
Yeah. It's the war room.
You know what I mean?
War room, Castle Grayskull.
Exactly. What's that shit the X-Man be working out in?
The
that's Xavier's
room.
House.
This the danger room.
No, the danger room. I thought that was just a nigga house.
Well, look, man, the trap is doing
a room in the house. He got a big house, though.
Oh, yeah. All right, gotcha.
He got a lot of money in that settlement that crippled him.
Yeah.
Well, look, man, since the trap doing such numbers, we had to figure out what was the most viewed trap episode.
What was the most viewed trap episode?
Yeah.
This year.
This year. I'm talking about, we did some numbers in this trap.
Did some numbers, for real.
That's a lot of numbers. I'd be looking at the numbers.
You can take a guess who you think it was.
Most numbers?
Most.
This year?
This year.
Yeah.
Don't even worry about it. Go to the clip.
We'll go to the clip.
You got it.
He a real nigga, ain't he?
First of all, you a real nigga. And his voice is deep as shit.
No.
It's the craziest thing I've ever heard.
What the real Michael Jackson voice sound like.
Man, that's a new episode.
Hey, man, hold up. Wait a goddamn minute. Nav, you remember I said that shit?
Hey, yeah. Bruh, I was bullshit earlier. I'm glad you let me meet T-Pain.
Bruh, wait a fucking minute. Hold up, man. What the fuck the real Michael Jackson voice sound like?
It was between where you think Michael Jackson is and Prince. It was in between that. It was just like, it was kind of like, I don't have a deep one. Listen, so I think Michael's was like a, so what kind of cartoons do you watch? It was deadpan like that though. It was looking square in my eyes. So what kind of cartoons do you watch?
The most viewed trap episode this year.
Come on.
T-Pain.
Thank you, guys. First and foremost, I want to thank God. Also want to thank the devil a little bit. God wouldn't have anything to do if it wasn't for the devil. So, you don't want God to die of boredom. So that's something we gotta have. I wanna thank Oasis, Good Time Emporium. I just wanna thank Atlanta all together, and I just wanna say I'm proud of y'all boys. You're doing good. Congratulations on all the success. Congratulations on Channel 85, everything y'all doing. I'm better than everybody else. Thank you. I appreciate y'all.
Hey.
That's right.
Come on, man.
Just put it in your pocket.
You ain't never had an award you can put in your pocket, right?
We got a handheld award.
Just to see.
Hey, man, no disrespect to our award like that.
He gonna forget it's in there and then put that coat in the closet and go to wear it next year and be like, what the fuck is this
thing in this?
And they gonna tear up your dry cleaner.
I got a motherfucking award and $20.
No, man, we appreciate you coming through the trap, man.
Thank you.
That
thank
you
all for having me, man. I don't usually get invited to places twice.
That episode did numbers. It was interesting as hell. You gave us one of the best Michael Jackson stories. Nicki Minaj reached out via
the internet.
Y'all gonna do the track or what?
Double time.
We working on something. We working on something. She did hit me. So we.
Now I see you trolled the shit out of it. T-Pain trolled the shit out of the internet last week. Did y'all see that? He told everybody that his shit was getting. Yeah.
Man, you
played too fucking much, man.
I was like, man, I just streamed one of his albums just because I knew that nigga was bullshit.
I waited till the views got all the way up and then replied. Y'all really believe this shit?
It was a social experiment. I just wanted to show people how they pay so much attention to it. I had not gotten that many views on a video.
You was acting your ass off, though, so you just gonna take it?
There's been so many weird things happening, man. But, that's my highest view video in the last three months.
Yeah, you know how much money you got to have to want to pretend to be broke? Like, that's a different level of finance when you got so much money that you just like, man, let me just pretend I don't got all this goddamn money.
It was just some people talking shit on the internet, and I kind of wanted to make them happy for a quick couple days and then just ruin the rest of their life just with a quick little video. No problem, come back through. Every time I lose one, I bounce back with two. Ooh. I told you that now. Hey, so it wasn't no malicious shit. I just wanted to shut up a couple people.
That was
a
social experiment.
That's rich people talking for fucking around. We're gonna do a social experiment.
Yeah.
Let's call it the ghetto.
It was a social experiment. Niggas was real happy though. They was very, very, very happy.
How did that make you feel, like to see how happy people get to think you have a demise in your life? Like, what?
That's pretty funny because everybody claims that they don't get happy about that shit, and everybody want to see you fail. It's easier. It puts everybody else's mind at ease to know that the celebrities are normal people, that, oh, they have hard times too. This man shit just like us, and then I shit on everybody. And then all of a sudden, I'm an asshole again.
Well, I tell you what,
it was okay when I was down.
I don't want to see you fail, nigga. I seen that Lamborghini outside. I was like, somebody around this motherfucker been cutting checks.
Yeah.
Like, nah, I seen that Lamborghini. I didn't know you was coming there. I seen that Lamborghini. I was like, man, me and Lowe's got to have a conversation, my nigga.
You was here before I was, and I'm like, this motherfucker been holding out the whole time. I really thought it was either you or Clayton, because, you know, this nigga is.
Yeah,
busy.
I didn't even think that guy Clayton was coming on the helicopter.
No. I saw it. I said, oh, Lambo!
Christmas came.
Oh, man.
For real.
The social experiment part of it is still actually going, because there's people that didn't see the second video. So anytime I say anything about finances on the internet, they still like, didn't you just get your shit repoed? And I'm like, sure. Well, yeah, all right. So don't listen to me. It's fine. But I mean, hey, look, man, that's how people are. Welcome to the internet.
Do you think that comes from the fact that you ain't, you know, really put out no music, and that's why people think that you could get your shit?
He did put some new music.
I mean, I'm talking about.
He got sex dolls in the video.
I know, but
he thought I wasn't going to say shit about it. T-Pain on there singing to a plastic bitch. He got in the car, she all. How many did he have?
He had a bunch of them.
He done put them in little poses and shit. They got their nails done. I'm like, what the hell are you doing?
Time out. See, that's what I mean.
Now you got another one called Shoot Up the Club.
I didn't see
Shoot
that.
Up the club.
What I mean by putting out music is, I mean, you were at one time really probably the biggest artist in music.
Yeah.
And then people don't see you as the biggest no more, so mm-hmm. they just think that you haven't.
Of course.
You know
I mean, people don't look into anything. Niggas don't read comments. Credits no more. Shit like that, so they don't see when I'm behind the scenes. I'm just seeing when Grammys from other niggas album coming to my house. You know what I'm saying? So right. It's like,
Man, your studs be so subtle.
It's just that outside truth ain't my truth no more. Back in that time, my whole brain would just be, I need everybody to know I'm dope. And now it's just, as long as my kids and my wife are good,
you know
what these niggas talk about.
Can you bring back Top Hat T-Pain?
You know what? I want
that
to.
That nigga was a fool.
He was.
That's
the one that made Long Lap Dance song. that's the T-Pain that made Long Lap Dance song.
Yeah, that T-Pain was not. That T-Pain wasn't a good person.
Mm.
So,
you wasn't a good person at that?
Nah.
So you deserve that shit Nicki Minaj did to you then?
probably. That was before that. I think I got real bitter and shit after a while. So that T-Pain wasn't a good person. Top hat T-Pain, he'll just show up with a top hat, you know, and not be on some kind of drugs. You gotta, yeah, well, I don't know.
You can't just wear the hat. You can't just wear the hat.
It's gotta go with something. You gotta be on something.
You ever go in the bathroom late at night and the light flipping, top hat T-Pain be in the mirror looking at you like, remember how much fun we had?
What happened to us, man?
Why? Pick up the hat, man!
This man was splashing water on his face.
Oh, shit!
God damn.
I'm good.
Yeah, I'm good,
man. Come on, man. Let's get back to it. You know, you got to.
I have another question for you. Do you still have any Nouveau anywhere?
You know what? You still got Nouveau, don't you? Yes, we still got one bottle.
You know what you should do with it? You should make it an NFT.
A bottle of Nouveau.
NFT for real. That's
how is that NFT now?
Because nigga, don't nobody coming else from got you. This shit but you, and it's coming from you. Nouveau from T-Pain, motherfuckers.
And better. They can't drink it in the real world, but they can drink it
in the metaverse.
You be up on everything.
Y'all got to stop thinking together.
Why not? These are beautiful. That's how all this came about, baby. These type of ideas. I'm telling you, NFT to Nouveau.
NFT.
T-Pain presents Nouveau and just put that shit out, man. You're making
it. It's got to be some kind of limitation. NFT can be.
No, you can buy property with them. They just did it in Kiev somewhere. I'm trying to figure this shit out.
You really can buy property in the metaverse. Like, you can buy houses and land and all that. So you can have people stock they metaverse house with Nouveau.
Yeah, Mark Knight hitting back on that one.
Who is Mark Knight?
I said Mark is not hitting back on that one.
Oh, Mark.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Zuckerberg.
Yeah,
that was
Zuckerberg.
Talking about
it no more? Stop, don't even listen to this. So I hit him. I was like, yo, let me get like some property in the joint. Two checks on WhatsApp, nothing back. What's going on? Like, this is like a regular thing. Like me and Mark go back and forth a lot. As soon as I asked him about that property though, he was like, next subject.
Fuck out of here, nigga.
I can't hear you, I'm in the metaverse.
That's what I'm saying, bro. I don't wanna go to the metaverse if I still gotta be a nigga in there. Like that. It's a waste of time, bro. Gotta be a nigga in the
metaverse. You don't buy all the other stuff.
You have to buy multiple.
You didn't
shit.
Walk into the conversation, you just hit him straight up about the shit.
Well, first I said congratulations on the metaverse. That's a big deal. That's a huge fucking thing. About to change the world. And then, right after that, I was like, what's up with, you know, some property on there? Crickets.
Little T-Pain Island.
You gotta hit him back. I was like, I was gonna buy it.
Don't think that, Mark.
You know what you gotta
we
do?
We got money too.
You gotta put the top hat on and hit him again.
Oh man.
That's the only way he's gonna respond.
Let me in there, T.
Gotcha.
Look, man.
I had a solid flex. I was in the whatchacallit for it now when they did the announcement about it. Mm-hmm. And he was going through his contacts. I was in the contacts now. I had a solid flex. I was pretty goddamn good.
I should have showed up.
Damn, should have been in the commercial. That makes sense. Go ahead. Y'all do y'all thing. Yeah, right, we're supposed to be doing something else here.
We're giving out awards.
You got an award.
Yeah. That's like
I got mine. This is it, right?
We got some more.
There's some more awards.
All right, we got to give this award, man.
What's the award?
Man, it's been a rough year. And just by the things that Chico said about his mom throughout the show, people been watching over the years, man, you survived. She, like, that's some shit to wonder, say. That hashtag still lives in all the social circles, man. So the fans wanted to acknowledge and give you the Tawanda Sun Award.
That's good.
Come on, man.
Yeah. There it is.
Now keep in mind, that's from my real 85%ers, man, and they felt the connection and they felt like they know it just by the things that you've said throughout the years on stage and in the trap, and they wanted to let you know that they see you and they appreciate you.
Yeah, that's beautiful, man.
Yeah, this is dope, man. You know, it's been rough, you know what I mean, transitioning and getting to that point where you realize that the person that you was, you know, the closest to and that gave you the most level of ease and the world, like that was the first time I ever felt loneliness in my life when my mother passed away, because it didn't matter what I did, I knew it was always one person that was gonna ride with me, whatever. So having to transition through that has been tough, but having the love from the fans and just when I go out and do shows and getting back out and how people have just been receptive of the relationship that I've projected out on our show about our relationship is beautiful, man. So thank y'all, man, and rest in peace. Beautiful. This is all right right there, man. Give me a top hat. Change my name to Top Hat Tony.
Yeah, man, that's what these awards are all about, man. Just, you know, acknowledging that, you know, that we see what everybody got going on. Like,
well,
this next one.
No, I got one for you.
I bet.
I got one for you, because, you know what I mean, this is the 85 South show, but, you know what I mean, knowing where this comes from, like, I remember the conversations we had in the hotel room when we were shooting Wildin' Out the second season and just manifesting these things out of your brain, man, and look what it has turned into.
Yeah.
So because of that, I mean, when you really think about it, from the beginning to now, you have had perfect attendance. Exactly. So we got to give you the perfect attendance.
Come on, bro. There you go. First of all, hey, man, you don't miss it. You don't miss it. Ain't no missing. Yeah. I want to thank my goddamn self, man. I drove me here.
Who got you here?
I made this
all them days. Who woke you up?
Me!
The Lord. But these, no, yeah,
you right. The Lord.
Yeah,
and
but, yeah, no. But then you.
Man. It's not even about having perfect attendance, man. It's about being in proximity. You know, keeping things how it needs to be kept, man. This is all of a collective of us, man. And that's why this team's so unique, because everybody put a splash of themselves, literally, in the work.
Damn.
So shit, I'm always gonna have perfect attendance. If that's the case, this is a creative space to be in. And even after going on the road and doing shows, man, just to get back around some people who got some new, fresh ideas all the time, that's the shit that keep me motivated. So appreciate y'all
for
making this an environment that a motherfucker wanna be in. No, that's how we live in.
How much did it cost?
These? More than the ones we had last year.
Sit there over there, funny player.
They cost more than the ones we had last year. We had some bullshit last year.
But last year was bigger.
Last year, but nah, we had them goddamn woodshits. We gave one to Dion. I know that nigga ain't put that motherfucker up in his house.
They spelled his name wrong.
Yeah, they spelled his name wrong.
Somebody put Dijon Sanders on there. He don't want that shit. This man in the Hall of Fame.
He did not deserve that disrespect, man. Fuck, man.
DJ.
It wasn't like the other awards either. We had other awards that were similar. They were like big, but just for Dion, we decided to give him
the bullshit one. It's crazy.
My shit made out of driftwood.
You know, we next year we taking over the awards.
Yeah. It was a piece of driftwood with some googly eyes.
What's 6 year old pages?
It moved when you pick the shit up, G, man. Them eyes moved. It was like, nigga.
You, man, we having a black ass Christmas. We got a black Santa Claus and climbing a ladder. What the fuck is he on this ladder for?
Hey, man.
Yeah.
Get your ass off that ladder, Santa Claus.
That Santa stealing?
No, I need a ladder.
I'm sorry.
That's a Santa that go to only apartments.
Yeah.
Is that some black people shit? Little Christmas tree?
Yeah.
For real?
Yeah.
I must not be black enough. I ain't never seen one of these motherfuckers.
That's the tree you pull out when they be like, we gonna do a little something for Christmas.
Well.
When they be like, we got a few little gifts. This is what comes to mind when I hear that shit.
You make the tree small, the gifts look big.
Oh, my God.
Hey, it's the thought that counts.
I thought about getting
some. Let's give out some more
awards.
What you got, Chico?
Oh, man, we got to give out another award, man. The award that, you know, this is an essential award right here, because you can't ever diminish a motherfucker who comes through in the clutch. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about in the clutch. Always, you could depend on them to be there in the clutch.
Clutch.
At all times. Mm-hmm. Whenever, I ain't even said the nigga name yet. Back up.
Too late.
This nigga.
Too late.
Fuck, you getting paid by the minute, nigga? This nigga.
It's the Ghetto Awards, man. I want my nigga to have this shit. Boy, they even say it.
God damn, nigga. Say my nigga shit first. This nigga trying to come through in the clutch before I even get a nigga award.
We had some Soul Train dancers who was gonna bring
it. The clutch award goes to none other than Clayton English, man.
Come on, man. Appreciate it.
Appreciate it. And explain why my shit got a Band-Aid on it.
It's because it's for the clutch right there.
This shit say clutch with the Band-Aid.
Yeah.
Yes. This was the sample.
This was the sample. That was the first one they sent.
So good.
I know what I got.
Nah, you know why they gave it to you like that?
Because
the nigga wasn't going to get it, but he came through in the clutch.
See?
That's
sample.
That's what's up. But salute.
Who would you like to thank, man?
Huh?
Who would you like to thank?
Oh, I'd like to thank whoever wrote this.
That's about the most regular ass handwriting. Handwriting regular as fuck. You know, you can hand it to like a chick that do like little
you
swirls.
You could have done the loopy.
Nah,
I would have took
regular.
I would have took a smiley face into you. Look at what I get. Win is free agency.
Nah.
I'm taking my talents to South Beach.
No, you're not.
If I'm clutch, I'm getting the rap. This is the award I get. This ain't how they do the Super Bowl.
Oh,
everybody get a ring and then one nigga get a candy necklace? No. I want the clutch. I wanted to say clutch the long way.
All the way down.
So there we go. We got to get Clayton.
Appreciate it.
Okay, good. Hey, and we'll do it in the clutch.
We'll do it in the clutch.
Well, you'll be least expecting.
Oh, man. Appreciate
like, we over here bullshitting and things, but there's some people out here doing some big shit in the world.
Yeah.
And they need more recognition.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So you give it to them. I ain't getting them shit.
You ain't gonna give it to them.
Ain't gonna do it.
Because,
you know, it's the category. I don't know if somebody's trying to be funny or what.
I got you.
All right, go ahead, man.
I do it.
But this nigga got a physical award for that.
Go ahead.
Taking the value down of mine.
I don't know who thought that was worth getting an award for, but
I got you.
Whatever.
We gonna go ahead and do it, because this
you do it, because you give a fuck. I don't.
I respect it. You know what I mean? This award goes to a gentleman who has done something that he made sure that none of us will ever do. He made sure that none of us will ever be able to get this type of opportunity.
Oh, shit.
If he has anything to do with. Matter of fact, let's just run the clip.
Run the clip.
Bullshit.
No, play it again. Play it again.
Wow.
I want y'all to see that nigga hold the door.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Perfect.
My African. I told you he was gonna come back. Boy, why you didn't tell me you was bringing company? I would've cleaned up.
Uh-huh.
So you know this man? I definitely know this man. I know this man all the way live. You know, I know this man all up in the crevice.
Yes, it's very good to see you again.
Can you fast forward to now 40?
Oh, you gotta
man.
Game.
Oh,
I think he was supposed to be like
anymore?
The prince or something. He is not a prince anymore. He is
our king. I'm not about to watch the whole movie.
Oh,
man.
He's like, right about to now.
So you still got that smooth scepter?
You got
hey,
no.
You might want to hit on my birthday.
That's Jermaine. Oh, he did his thing.
Father.
All right, cut it. All right, cut
that's
it.
Enough, man. I done seen. Right.
No, that was.
As you can see,
he was in it.
That's not a real
he was
movie.
In it.
Repeat
best
it.
Appearance.
Over and over again. So, therefore.
Hold on, we got a special presenter. It's a special presenter.
Yeah.
It's
yeah,
a.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let go.
I'm saying, listen, I didn't know my man was coming. I'm sorry.
I didn't know. But this was a special request by Eddie Murphy. Not the real Eddie Murphy, the one on Bankhead who sell weed. But look at this right here. Best appearance in an Eddie Murphy film goes to none other than Navv Green.
Hey, y'all really got him on me.
Oh, man.
Man. Words just can't describe how I feel right now. A lot of people don't know, like, you know, where I came from and I said I wasn't gonna cry, but this shit just caught me off guard, man. First, I would like to thank Karlous, first and foremost, for giving me a chance, giving me a shot. A lot of niggas turned their back on me. You did too, but turned back around because I kept coming behind you.
Pause. But keep going.
Pause. any the misconception, Chico, DC, Clayton, and Los, man, I wasn't keeping 85 South from Eddie Murphy. I was keeping Eddie Murphy from the 85 South. Because when them type of niggas get hold of something genuine, they fuck it up. And I didn't want them to fuck up with what y'all created and built for niggas like me. I just like to thank all the 85%ers who voted me for this, because anybody could have won this award, but, yeah. And before I leave, I also want to know why I didn't get an award along with T-Pain, because I was on that episode as well. But we'll say that for next year. Be blessed.
Salute to Navv Green. That nigga wore a turtleneck for this shit.
Yeah, like, he definitely wore it for
it's,
this.
It's definitely
a whole little suit.
A whole little suit, man.
You know he ain't got nothing to do after this. Suit.
That was literally the one he was supposed to wear to the premiere, but. They're like, man, you ain't even walking the red carpet, bro. You going around the back, man. Don't need trip off that shit.
I'm going with Burgundy.
And Burgundy. This nigga wore his red carpet movie outfit to come and stunt on us.
I'ma kill him with this.
That nigga really was in a movie with Eddie Murphy, bro. He tell nobody he knew us. None of us. That shit crazy, bro. I bet you Clayton told the Hawkeye people he know us.
Damn. Well, damn.
She didn't? No. You know I didn't.
You know I didn't.
Look at my award. Hey, man, it ain't never strange, is it?
He
didn't tell nobody.
Damn.
You know, Hawkeye can't hear.
That is true.
He can't. He has a hearing aid. He has trouble here. I didn't want him to think I said something else. 85 sound. 85 hit you in the sound. Mouth. That's not what I said.
That's not what I said.
At least you got a better excuse than this nigga. He didn't have a better excuse. He just sat there and looked at Lowe like, I don't know what to say.
No, I don't want them to, you know. I don't want them.
You don't want them to know?
Same thing Navv said.
Same thing.
I want them.
Very good.
Come and just Mickey Mouse. What you
think? You don't want Mickey to come over here, nigga. Come on, man. He can't be over here no
more. Mm-hmm. What?
Be Goofy sitting in that chair.
Oh, welcome to the 85th.
Oh, man. I feel you.
Welcome to the 85th. Should be all digital. We'd be some damn cars.
You're right. You got a good point. Hey, man, learn from him, man.
I see how it is, man.
You got to say fuck niggas.
You got to protect the I know how important being independent is. I can't believe I'm out here just telling mother. All right, man.
Who you promoting the squad?
I'm out here just. Don't tell nobody else.
I won't.
I'm
out here just throwing y'all names in places they don't even have to be.
What places?
Places. I be places.
It do be places.
I'm in the shit I'm in now. Stop bringing my name up, man. See how it is.
So Clayton said he gonna put up 20 G's, and then I'm gonna put up another 20 G's.
I'm speaking your name in circles, man.
Oh my God.
What opportunities are.
No, I brought you up.
Okay, man.
I brought it up. I said, I do a podcast with my friend.
Not your little friend, bro. They're not gonna take that shit.
I think he just said that because we all shorter to him. I think that was what he meant. Okay. He didn't mean little physically. As in physically.
I didn't say little friend.
But that's how it's gonna come across. Man, let's just go on to some other shit.
I'm gonna say I do it.
That's
with
all
people.
Good, man. It's a new year, new you things, it's new opportunities, on. Man.
Go ahead. Next
I know who I won't be calling this year. Just doing all myself.
Doing great.
Put myself in there.
No, I wasn't even supposed to be there.
I know. Man, that's okay. Me and Bruce Willis working on some shit. I ain't said nothing about none of y'all.
I know. He ain't know I knew. He gonna be in the Seventh Sense.
Yeah. Seventh Sense?
Exactly.
It's the sequel to the Sixth Sense.
I got a whole scene by myself.
Same little boy?
Yeah.
He grown?
He grown. He's still seeing shit.
What do you see now?
Motherfuckers that might, you know. He's seeing that type of shit.
Like what?
He's saying motherfuckers who might, you know what I'm saying? It's like he could predict like shit that's about to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you about to die.
Kinda, but it ain't that. He know the future and shit. It kinda like Neo with no weapons.
Mm.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
But then you find out I can't do that part.
Plot twist. You can't even talk about NDA. That's crazy.
NDA. NDA young boy.
Don't worry about it.
All I'm saying is,
when y'all start seeing me on shit, don't wonder why. Nav, you know your water cut off.
You already be on shit. Everybody be on shit. That's the beautiful part.
That's what I'm saying, though. But I wouldn't just be over there with Eddie Murphy and not tell him about my partner and him. I would have told him, everybody on Instagram, man, pull it up on your phone, Eddie Murphy. You ain't seen the shit, Lee.
You would have told him to pull it up on the phone?
Hell yeah.
Did you ever, did anybody ever ask, did he really ever get to talk to Eddie, though?
He did. They was laughing and bullshitting and everything. I seen some behind the scenes footage. They was outside taking pictures with Martin and shit.
Nav showed up one day. Did you ever have any one-on-ones?
Oh, yeah,
they
was. And then, you know, Nav, he was jumping in pictures that didn't have shit to do with him.
That's what I'm saying.
So he was in the all-ladies pictures. It was the women of Coming to America, and this nigga was sitting in that picture.
All right, let's keep the awards.
All right, man. We always looking at the numbers, man. So we're going to move to the award for the most viewed live show. Roll the footage.
Oh, shit.
Y'all be having the most problems with them hair, them beauticians, lady. The bitch said the appointment was at 1:30. You get there at 1:30. This bitch ain't there. She walk in with both her babies.
With both of them?
Both of them. I'm so sorry, baby. I had a babysitter, but she couldn't come. So I'm going to do your shit with the babies here. Baby's running up on you. What's your name?
This is snotting on little baby, too.
I ain't seen you before. My mommy always do your hair.
They put up with that shit. These stylists got a long list of shit. Don't keep texting me. Don't show up at my house unannounced. Come with your shit. Wash and blow dry and part it with the rubber bands already on it. And you can only use this specific shit on it, or I ain't gonna fuck with your shit. Y'all put up with that shit, so I got a list of
y'all
shit that they gotta do before they come over my house.
I ain't big right,
man, I'm gonna come over
what
there with
this?
The pussy I already ate.
This it? Also, I guess Megan is the most viewed live show.
Go, Megan is the most viewed live show. Jesus. Most viewed live show. Megan.
Oh! Megan.
For the most viewed live show, MacTown, make it.
Man, yeah, only on air.
Who gets that? Okay.
Oh, okay. Okay.
What?
Who does that go to?
It's the most viewed live show on the app.
On the app.
On Channel 85.
Oh, okay.
So that's the one that got the most viewed on Channel 85.
So what do? You send that to Macon?
No, I'ma get this shit to Joe.
Joe, give it up for Joe.
Joe, you gotta take it down to Macon.
Hey, Joe, give him a speech, man. They've been hearing your laugh. They wanted to see you. You gotta accept the award.
They wanna match your laugh with the Macon.
Joe, accept the award, man.
Hey, speech, Joe.
Hey, put the.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Joe.
Yeah.
I just wanna shout out the whole team, the whole production staff, J-O-N, everybody that put this shit together. Thank you.
Joe ain't different type of nigga. Joe got on a goddamn hoodie with a scarf on the outside, nigga.
Let me find out J-O-N got more to do with this show.
Yeah.
Hey, man, J-O-N and everybody else.
What the fuck J-O-N been doing? He does more than this.
Yes.
You know, I always send J-O-N the last cut just to get it.
Just to make sure to get it.
Everything goes through J-O-N. Sometimes with his ladies, because I'm waiting on him. T-Pain over there drinking.
Nigga, you ain't got a sneak.
I don't want that drinking hookah water.
I don't want to interrupt. Y'all want some of that shit here?
Does your jacket just have that in it? I thought that was a hookah.
I did. I thought the nigga was about
to. This nigga got hookah. He better drink some hookah water.
T-Pain was gonna float out there, motherfucker. That shit looked like a genie bottle, nigga.
Y'all want some drinks? To drink.
We drunk.
Got drunk.
Hey, man. Hey, but one thing about your songs, they never stop playing them bitches.
Hey, man, because it's situational.
That's how I knew that car, I knew that.
What?
When they had the car shit? When he said it was
$10. Oh, man, of course. That was like, nigga, ain't no way T-Pain should get represented. And they don't start with the Rolls Royce. That's not the shit they come get when you get your shit repossessed. It's not the Rolls Royce. They come get your living room set. That's when you know it's real.
When nigga break your bed down.
That's the last motherfucking thing to go. You gonna end up living in that bitch before all your shit gonna be gone. They gonna come get your living room set first, nigga. Now, if he'd have put up a video with his goddamn shower curtains and shit getting taken out, then I'd have been like, oh, it's fucked up with T-Pain out here.
They take the food at your refrigerator.
Niggas took leftovers.
Niggas crank your ice trays and get all the ice. Nigga don't need no luxuries around this bitch. Then they turn your freezer all the way up to 8 and get hot.
Kill everything you might have left.
Oh shit.
Nothing left.
Then they give me one. I only want.
Okay. T-Pain want to do one. This is a good one for you to do too.
Yeah.
All right.
Shit. Hell yeah.
Oh yeah.
This is a pretty prestigious award here. Something that's very near and dear to my heart and something my whole very dear. This is it's a musical kind of thing. So I just want to say that anybody that can keep up with y'all boys on stage and stay with y'all when it's time to really get into the groove and know exactly when to start jamming and things like that, I mean, that's got to be some kind of special. You know what I'm saying? It's very rare that you can just hop on the stage with some musicians and just be able to, you know, make magic. You know what I'm saying? And still have it be on time and still let y'all have y'all comedic time and things like that. So I want to give the award for the coldest band in the land. Let's show the clip, please.
All them boys.
That's another song right there.
Shut up, Flat.
Listen. Nigga, we think that it ain't really about it. I'ma go ahead and talk up about it. Yeah. They thinking they don't really do it. Ain't new to this. Well, I'm true to this. I would use popping the pills up on the corner though. Nigga Ryan here, boy, yeah, they'll owe me though.
All right.
Yes. Hey, hey,
motherfucking
Bando.
Come on, give it to them.
Oh, y'all don't have multiple? Okay, that's fine.
Bando.
Just, okay.
Yeah. We got no wars out in the beach.
Turn your mic on.
Yep. No, not at all.
Appreciate
you. I try to do what I can.
Yo, I want to shout out to, I have something on behalf of my Bando brothers. Shout out to Los and Chico and DC Clay, the whole crew. Appreciate y'all. All the fine ass women to come on the show. Thank y'all so much too as well. Peace.
Yes. Oh, so the groupies? Y'all got the groupies?
Yeah.
Boy, that's what I was talking about.
Yeah.
What the fuck I be having? They be coming through.
Not at the show.
Okay, let's go. That makes sense.
Come to the show. We got one in Atlanta next Saturday.
Come you. Hey, what's up? It's Karlous Miller here. It's the end of the year, so let's make sure we end it on a good note with some Blue Chew. Blue Chew is a unique online service that delivers the same active ingredients as Viagra and Cialis, but in chewable tablets and at a fraction of the cost. That's right. Blue Chew tablets are made in the USA. They prepare and ship direct to your door in a discreet package, so don't nobody even know what you ordered. The process is simple. Sign up at BlueChew.com, consult with one of their licensed medical providers, and once you're approved, you'll receive your prescription within days. So if you can benefit from some extra confidence when it's time to perform, Blue Chew can help. The best part? It's all done online, so no visits to the doctor's office, no awkward conversations, and no waiting in line at the pharmacy. So check this out. We got a special deal for our listeners. Try Blue Chew for free when you use promo code 85SOUTH at checkout. Just pay $5 for the shipping. That's BlueChew.com, promo code 85SOUTH to receive your first month free. Visit BlueChew.com for more details and important safety information. And we thank Blue Chew for sponsoring the podcast. I'm interrupting this program with some more breaking news. That's right. Return of the Ghetto Legends. We're going out west. January 7th, and guess where the show is? At the LA Forum. Yep, we're right there. I'm throwing up some powder like LeBron. It's going crazy. January 7th, go to the website and get the tickets. Or go to the app. You don't got the app. You don't want to come to this show. But January 7th, we in L.A. Shit. Get the tickets. Me, Chico, D.C. Still ain't found me no new opener yet, though. Still ain't found me no new opener. Send me those clips. January 7th, Return of the Ghetto Legends. Merry Christmas. I get with you. Let me do this next one.
Okay.
Because this one, I'm skipping. Because I got to say it.
Skipping?
Yeah. I'm skipping around.
Where are you skipping to?
Okay. Because, man, I want to just get to this right now.
Okay.
Shout out to the whole black market.
Black market? Yes.
The whole black market. If you a black person and you sell anything, shout out to you. So I want to give a shout out to the black market. You know, that's what we use our platform to highlight and spotlight, you know, black people, black business owners who are doing things in the community, you know, branching out and, you know, just trying to take it to the next level with the entrepreneurship, man. So roll the clip.
Duncan, you
had no idea, did you?
I didn't have an idea, yes.
You did? You
I was just in my head, I was singing.
Shout out to L. Duncan.
Like,
you can sing it.
Yeah. I had the one that had a quarantine baby.
What?
He knocked me up. I was like, I'm not a lady.
What?
So I just decided that I spent my time looking fine, pregnant as fuck, but I don't care because he's gone.
Turn it off. Stop. That's enough.
He's passed.
ESPN okay. Might see this clip. We got the ESPN lady on the in the trap custody. Most viewed black market episode goes to L. Duncan.
Shout out to L, man.
Since L. Duncan is not here, well, we have someone who's very more, someone else here to accept her award on behalf of her.
Oh. Long way, strong way.
I gotta play the clip.
All right, do it again.
Set it off. This is your boy Chris, set it off, Joe. Hey, man, we out here wilding in the back, man. Hey, y'all, chill out for real. Hey, yo, girl, I apologize. Very special moment right now. Since she couldn't be here right now, we have a clip for L. Duncan. L, over to L, please.
Wow. I don't even know what to say. Thank you so much for all of you that watched my appearance in the Trap House with Los. It was fantastic, and it meant so much to me. And obviously, it meant so much to the 85 South Comedy Show that they didn't send me an actual award. So thank you. Thank you so much for this half-empty water bottle and for allowing me to come and just cut it up with you for a couple of hours. It was fantastic. And now, Karlous, you have to make your way up to Bristol. In the meantime, forever I love Atlanta. Thanks, y'all.
Yay! Well, on behalf of Elle, since she's not here, we have someone else to accept her award. Ladies and gentlemen, Navv Green.
On behalf of L. Duncan.
Hey, man.
Thank you.
Hey, man. You trying to get the most out of this suit.
Yeah, I know. Turtleneck terrorist, nigga.
That nigga going out the most with the least.
The turtleneck terrorist. We in here.
Hey, man, that was some black ass shit, though. L just used
the Sports Center set.
Yeah.
To give us an award, bro. Yeah. And accept her award.
You might not need to show that clip.
Yeah, but nah,
might have to blur it out.
She ain't say nothing.
She gonna be in the HR office.
Right.
So, about your little trap or something.
Yeah. All clips. We just want to show you what type of content your guys are putting out. We have a whole bunch of clips of Los talking about titties and shit. So you feel comfortable being there? Is that?
Bro, all right, I'll fuck around, bro. For real. All right. I fuck with
him. Look, we have a lot of guests here in the trap, man. So we asked the people online, who was their favorite musical guest?
Oh, shit, I get two awards?
Let's roll the clip and see.
God damn it.
The process of you making those records, remember, you just singing. You just going in and singing. Mm-hmm. Who was that?
That was music. Music, so, all right, again, since we're talking about these, because you got to understand, like, I live with these
Everybody does.
Vibes, you know what I'm saying, all day. Music is the dude that goes to work every day.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and again, just as a disclaimer, I understand how this may come across, but this is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
So music, everybody knows music. Music goes to work. Music does his job. Music don't complain. Music right. don't talk shit. Music don't talk back. Like, music just does his job. He about to get into lunch. Period.
Great guy.
Yes. You know what I'm saying? But
a duffel bag.
You know what I'm saying?
Who's in here? Oh, Purple Wonderland. Anybody wanna talk to Purple Wonderland?
He was being so serious. We have an acceptance speech for him right now. So,
yeah.
Hey, yo, what up? It's Music Soul Child. I just want to send a big shout out to 85 South and all the people that have supported me and voted me as favorite musical artist of the year. I think that's crazy. Like, out of everybody? Like, everybody?
Except T-Pain.
Yeah, that's some dope people that came through. So it's definitely an honor. I appreciate it. Thank you. And God bless everybody.
That's not the, name of the award.
He's the best artist in the world.
They say he couldn't be here. This is my time, guy. My time. He couldn't be here tonight, but we have someone else, a very special guest, to accept the award on his behalf. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Navv Green.
Come on, man.
This nigga, man.
Come on, man.
Nah.
Music couldn't be here.
Really?
Thank you, everyone.
Hey, man, salute the music, man.
Sure.
Hey, man, music. You can tell music.
You know what I'm saying?
You can tell music was at the house because the neck on his t-shirt, that's the only thing. Pull the picture back up.
Look at the neck on my nigga's t-shirt.
Stop, bro. That's Purple Wonderlove. Purple Wonderlove.
Oh, my
bro,
God.
That motherfucker, boy, that's... Woo.
Fresh out of a fight.
Man, yeah, that's when you at the crib, nigga. You chilling with your neck on your t-shirt look like that.
Oh, boy.
Salute to music, man. That was, you know... Now, let me ask you this. Now, why can't you take a page out of music's book and make Top Hat T-Pain, like, its own, you know what I mean? Like, personality, where you just tap into that and put, like, a EP out. And
not a good person.
I don't have the mental capacity to deal with my one personality. I'm trying to figure that shit out.
Well, music has like nine.
I've been lectured by all of them. So I've seen all of them.
What?
He's a good dude, man.
He's a great
Purple Wonderlove before.
You ever worked with Purple Wonderlove?
I haven't worked with Purple Wonderlove.
Why not? Purple Wonderlove, Top Hat T-Pain, joint EP.
Y'all keep giving out these awards the wrong way. I can't come back up here, man. That's. I appreciate it. Thank you. I'm favorite music guest.
That was
is it because his name is music and then that's just the favorite is the favorite nigga's name music that's been up here.
Nah, because once he started breaking down the personalities, it was over with, man. That shit went crazy.
It's filled with a Q on there.
Yeah.
That was like nine different people we had in one interview, so you had to accept. Yeah, man. Y'all, it's hard to just beat nine people.
Y'all must film this shit in an 18-wheeler, because this shit big rigged, and I keep this, and I'm taking them bars home with me off the motherfucking dome.
Damn, man. Yeah, this the shit out of us.
And our own award show.
T-Pain, this not the fucking Source Awards, man.
No.
This ain't the Soul Train Award. This is the Ghetto Legends Award. Damn.
That nigga really came up here and told us he made music as nine different people.
Oh, man.
And the fans like five of them, so it's hard to beat this nigga. We didn't know the other four.
Right.
Y'all continue on. I'm taking this award.
Go. All right, cool.
All right, man.
Well, look, in the process of doing the black market, man, I ran into some young moguls out here, man. Yeah. I'm talking about some
some young business-minded kids that will really make you think that they already grown with, like, as far as the, you know, the mental capacity and, like, how they are in business, man. You know what? I can't even explain it. Just roll the clip, man.
We'll make somebody finance our five-minute movie.
Money.
Yeah.
I like cash.
Really? So we'll set it up. We'll do a whole movie, and then I'll show y'all the game, all right?
Okay.
I'm going to show y'all how to get. And then we'll get some residuals. We'll get some agents. We'll get some Corvettes. We'll do a premiere. It'll just be us because we can't invite everybody.
Okay. So I like Corvettes, but Bugatti, Venom.
That's a $2 million car. We're not even about to play with them people like that. Nah, we'll stick with a Bonneville or something. Not messing with no Bugatti. So what?
He ain't know about them Bugattis, man.
Hey.
So look, man, we want to give the Future Mogul Award to those kids right there.
Absolutely.
Those three children that are in that video, man, because see, they reached out to us because they redid our intro to the BET Awards last year.
Right.
So I guess we got a clip. Hold on, we gotta watch the clip.
Yeah.
That's my man Nicholas right there.
Wow, it's such an honor to be receiving this award from the 85 Festival.
Yeah.
I hear I can be there to accept it in person, but I'm here in Ghana working on my humanitarian projects. I'll be there soon to hold my award. I'd like to thank the team, Chico Bean, DC Youngfly, J-O-N, Ryan, and everyone else. I'd also like to thank Karlous Miller for hosting the Black Excellence segment and for shining light on Black-owned businesses. I'd also like to thank my crew, Kevin and Chine. Thanks for holding down my parody video. Until next time, peace.
Told you.
In Ghana. Little buddy in Ghana.
Shout out to Nicholas. Big move.
Wow.
Rich Nick. He said he was over in Ghana, didn't he?
Right.
Hey, shout out to Kwame Nkrumah. Hey, you know, hey, that connection over there with African and Black America. Hey, check this out, though. But since Nicholas couldn't be here, we have someone else on Nicholas' behalf.
Who is?
Who you're not even gonna believe is here to accept this award. Ladies and gentlemen, you never believe this. Give it up, Navv Green.
It's an honor to accept this on behalf of Nicholas because, like him, I was a young dreamer myself. On behalf of Nicholas and the 85%ers, we just wanna say thank you.
Yeah.
Hey.
Can you believe this shit?
I can't. I think Nick that's is only, already more successful
than
all of us.
You did that intro. It was a whole
last
intro.
Last time, it was Paul Myers.
Yeah. Now it's just that
this
nigga.
Time. They won an award, too. We got to give out an award.
Poor suit.
Oh, my God, man.
You know, after last year's awards, we had to come up with a category just so they could win.
Right.
But they earned this one.
What's this?
Oh,
one?
Yeah. For the, look, for
oh,
the
yeah, that talked
Pour
about.
Your Heart Out Award.
Oh, yeah. Talked about.
Go to clip.
A lot of y'all got a real fucked up perception about how good your pussy is, too.
Well, I personally believe.
Hold on, wait a minute. That clip too good. That clip went way too viral. You need to watch that whole episode. I'm not even going to spoil you with that clip.
Don't do a clip.
Nah, because that went everywhere. There are 100 plus YouTube argument videos about that clip, so you got to find that on your own.
Yeah, mm-hmm. But salute to the beautiful ladies with poor minds.
Hold up.
Oh, shit.
You know, the disrespect is just so, it's just rampant out here. But for the Pour Your Heart Out Award, we give it up for, well, Pour Your Heart Out Award, give it up for Poor Minds. And they're not here right now. But we have someone on their behalf.
Ooh.
Ladies and gentlemen, Navv Green.
Hey, man, call him by his full name or something. Don't nobody know it. No. It's Navadius.
Man, it's just crazy. I was just on their podcast.
Navadius.
So on behalf of that, I would like to accept the award for Pour Your Heart Out Award. Huh? Who? Call who? Say it loud. What? Be patient right quick. I would like to call up the producer who produced the show for Pour Your Mind, director.
edit all that out. Give it up for Tahir.
Appreciate y'all. Poor Minds every Friday, 7 o'clock. Check that out. And appreciate the opportunity to be able to create.
Yeah.
So much better.
All our production staff dress homeless, nigga. Is that something we did on purpose? Like, is that just naturally how the shit just ended up?
Like, you gotta keep in mind, they the type of creative where, like, creative, the man. More homeless they look, the better they fit.
Okay.
They're not, those clothes, that's actually from the Yeezy collection.
They're expensive.
That shit is very expensive.
Yeah. Those holes were strategic.
You laughing at Joe, but that's yeah. fucking Louis scarf.
I know.
From Joe, the 80s.
I know, that's what I'm saying. They dress homeless, but the clothes are expensive. That's absolutely. That's an ode to how we operate
expensive
over here.
Homeless
and expensive homeless shit.
Well, since you brought up the crew and shit.
Mix it up with H&M.
We got to give out this special award, you know, because there's certain people on the staff that go over and beyond.
Yes.
Above and beyond.
Above and beyond. It ain't no telling what you might see these motherfuckers doing. A nigga might be driving a van.
I can't even start this one.
Behind a camera or editing some footage or picking up some weed or dropping off somebody at the airport. You never know what you might need. Nigga might run, you might need a sandwich.
Right.
A barbecue chicken wing or something. So this year we created the Swiss Army Knife Award. That yeah. means the motherfucker can do damn near everything. Roll the clip.
Thad. What's up, Thad?
What happened, Thad, man? That nigga graduated.
Hey, what's happening? Congrats, fool. Where you graduated from?
Georgia State.
We
got Thad over there. Right, he ain't really doing shit, but we fucked right with up. The nigga, so you ain't got to miss. Hey, oh.
You mean to tell me Thad don't even know how to turn the camera on?
This is the most I remember, man.
Ice, man. That nigga Thad on thin ice.
I'll tell you one person who's happy you came here today. My boy Thad.
But me looking directly up, and he was just like sitting. Remember everybody hate Chris? You know, Chris.
Let me show the people how Thad's sitting there watching Johnny play.
Thad ain't had a shirt on since November. As soon as we said his name on camera, that nigga had 1,000 shots. Shout out to my boy Thad. Yeah.
For the Swiss Army Knife Award. Give it up for Thad, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, appreciate everybody from the 85 South, man. I want to give a special thanks to Karlous, Chico, Clayton, and T-Pain. And DC on Fly. I want to thank everybody, man. Y'all really created a foundation for me to be able to graduate college and come and create, man. So I really appreciate everybody on the cast and crew and 85 South.
My boy, Thad.
We helped him graduate.
I can't wait to say that.
What? I'm the reason these kids out here graduating.
Right.
Yeah. Can't wait to say that. I'm part of the reason a lot of these motherfuckers graduating.
Come on, man. I ain't had nothing to do with this shit, but I wanted to look that nigga T-Pain, in the face. I wanted him to look right at me and skip my name.
You played an intricate part.
I have nothing to do with this shit, but I wanted him to look
crucial
at me.
Crucial to Thad's graduation, T-Pain.
Yeah, I want to thank all these other niggas like I'm not here.
Right.
Hey, Chico, you know this is we making our award show official.
Yeah.
We even giving away a Lifetime Achievement Award.
Got a lifetime. Mm.
And like, tell them what that means.
Lifetime achievement means that you have achieved a lifetime worth of shit. No matter how long your life has been, you have achieved a lifetime worth of shit.
Absolutely.
I'm talking about you have done things that nobody thought you would be able to do in a lifetime. And you've accomplished those.
Absolutely.
You did more shit than you didn't.
You did way more shit than you didn't do. There you go. So, so
yeah.
We are glad here at the 85 South Shore Awards to give the Lifetime Achievement Award.
Well, look, we're just gonna roll the clip.
Oh, roll the clip.
We're rolling it.
Charlamagne has elevated himself to a level that most people probably didn't see. When you get a clear coat on your skin, right?
I'm always thinking about how I can help others because I feel like you rise when you lift up other people.
I want you to know he remixed your thought too. So
I just.
That's what they do. Hey, they still have something to
do. She's not gonna make no money for records like Switch. Switch is her.
Did you go to therapy at all? Because I feel like this is a lot to unpack. And I'm sure you're the go-to guy for a lot of people. So it's like, who does the go-to guy go to? So I'm sure you had to go to some therapy or something.
Nah, I use the world as my therapy, as my therapist.
Kev, my brother.
What up, Jim?
How are you, sir?
I'm good, dude.
The way you talk about Monk's Corner make motherfuckers want to go there. Even though we know the shit little as fuck, but when you talk about it, it make motherfuckers, like, I done rolled through South Carolina, and then you see the sign that
Monk's
says,
Corner.
But it's not, it's never close. It's always like 29 miles west of some shit.
Like, God lets things happen to you, so he can work through you. Yeah. And I think the easiest thing for me to do is just
Lifetime
Achievement
Award to none other
than
Charlemagne the God, a.k.a.
Winner
Tackle.
You got to accept the speech? Yeah, we got a speech. Hold on one second. These are the things that happens at a ghetto award show.
This is going to be edited out.
Nope. Joe ain't editing out shit. Ryan, you know that.
That's your computer?
Just a break in the action?
Huh?
You watch the show?
No, somebody got to check them fucking text messages down there, man. That shit's driving me crazy.
Fluidity. Great place for a commercial.
I don't know how y'all can see them red badges. I hate them shits. I just be checking.
Don't be reading nobody's messages, man.
Show everybody! It's over!
Oh, shit.
Check them texts, boy. Gotta get that badge off of there, or at least turn off the notifications. God damn. There we go.
All right. And we're back.
All right, bet.
Clip from Charlemagne the God.
Roll that Charlemagne footage.
I'm not gonna do it.
Hey, thank you to my good brothers of the 85 South Show, Karlous Miller, Chico Bean, DC Young Fly. Y'all already know how I feel about y'all, man. Y'all brothers are so important to the culture. I literally have watched all three of y'all come up in y'all own respective ways, you know, have seen y'all come together collectively to create something that's so powerful and so impactful, man. And honestly, whether people realize it or not, y'all giving folks a blueprint, man. You know, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, you know, Minister Farrakhan, they always say unity and group operation is a must. You know, unity and group operation, you got to pool your resources, and that's how we'll really thrive as a community, and y'all brothers are proving that. Y'all proving that just by being the three raw individual talents y'all are, and then combining those three resources to make this incredible collective called the 85 South Show, man. Y'all like the motherfucking, y'all like the Wu-Tang Clan of comedy. Y'all like the Dungeon Family, you know what I mean? Like everybody's dope in their own individual ways, but then everybody prospers collectively. So to receive this Lifetime Achievement Award from y'all, that shit means the world. Like, I'm not just saying that because y'all gave me the award. That shit really means the motherfucking world because y'all are culture, you know? Y'all are black, you know? Y'all are hip-hop. And I salute y'all, man, and I appreciate y'all for constantly appreciating me. And, you know, I've been riding with y'all for a long time, you know, since the beginning. And I'm gonna be riding with y'all long afterwards, you know. I talk to Chad all the time. I wanna see y'all in movies and, you know, TV shows. And I love that y'all got y'all own app, all of that good shit, you know. Whatever y'all doing, I'm supporting. And thank y'all for the Lifetime Achievement Award, man. Peace.
Now that's real. That's some dope stuff
somebody
right there.
Want to see us in movies?
That was dope.
Yeah, I know who don't. And they should. Hey, but like I say, man, hey, Charlemagne couldn't be here, you know, to get the Lifetime Achievement Award, and I'm damn about to take this motherfucker home. Look at man, we have someone else to accept this award for Charlemagne. It wouldn't be right if I didn't bring him up. Before I get my Instagram tag, follow me on Chris Jones Funny on social media. Give it up. To accept this award right now. Now. Good.
Somebody else do it. I put all shirts with it.
Five. Five.
Not to make this all, not to get too long with it, but if you look up the definition of lifetime, that's a time of life. And Charlemagne, you implement that, and I'm glad you wanted me to accept this award on your behalf.
And he asked, I don't think he asked anybody, did he?
T-Pain, you all mic'd up. As I was before I was rudely interrupted, we all are destined to live this life, but you want some achievement during the lifetime. So on behalf of the 85 percenters and Charlamagne, I will accept this award. Thank you.
Yeah. Very nice.
Yeah.
That was cool as hell, man.
Yeah.
Well, I feel like once you get up to Charlamagne's level, you gotta stop doing phone drops. You sure gotta be all DSLR all the time now. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got a cameraman. I know you got a cameman following you, right?
Damn,
you just do it, like, bro, don't.
You
like,
that privy to what shit looked like? Did you know that was filmed on a camera? Phone?
It wasn't even that. It, you know what? If it wasn't filmed on a phone, it was filmed on a very good camera with no microphone attachment. So.
them 13s
look crazy now. 4K, 60 frames. Go ahead, bro. Like, I get it, but, you know, after a while. Nah, I fuck with Charlamagne now. Charlamagne is the reason I sing how I sing now.
Really?
Yep.
You gotta explain that.
I went to his radio show in Carolina, and he had me, that was the first person that asked me to sing on the radio, and I did terrible. I was like, I was smoking cigarettes at the time. I had just did like 4 shows in a row, and I did terrible, and he embarrassed the fuck out of me. And after that, I was like, I gotta fucking figure out how I can always sound good all the time. And that he made me like up my fucking craft, and I really.
He made you start using auto-tune.
No, I was using auto-tune. He wanted to see how I sounded without auto-tune on the radio.
Oh, okay.
So when I sang live on the radio, I did bad. So after that, I was so embarrassed. I was like, oh, okay, I need to get my shit together. So when people ask me this now, I can just go.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying? But I mean, it wasn't, I don't think it was malicious. It was on some, you know,
that
nigga, just be, yeah, be better, nigga. Like, be ready for motherfuckers to ask you this shit. Like, he was teaching me a lesson, basically. So, shout out, Charlamagne.
Needless to say, you made it work, Mr. Payne. You made it work. That Lamborghini is proof.
That's all the
awards.
That's all the awards.
Damn.
All
right.
Good stuff. Mr. Payne want to give away that letter.
No, this
we
is
got
good.
One more award. We got one more award. We got to present one more award. So I guess we might as well, since it's along the lines of what we've been doing. This next award is given to, you know, our brother. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
Our brother.
You're right. You're right.
You know, one of the one of us, the core us,
yeah.
You know what I mean? And a pivotal part to the success of, you know, what we do over here at the 85 South Show. And as you can see, he is always, always working.
Always.
Always. Somewhere doing something at all times.
You got so, like 5 Christmas movies coming.
Exactly.
This Christmas, after
this Christmas,
Christmas.
After Christmas.
Christmas after
Monday
Christmas.
Kwanzaa.
Christmas Star, with Monique. Nigga in a British Christmas movie called Boxing Day.
Always. So.
Tyler Perry presents Christmas.
Christmas. You know, Dr. Umar Johnson presents Kwanzaa. He in that too. He in that too. So we gotta give us the award for no days off to none other than DC.
Young Fly. Let's go.
Yeah.
Man, go ahead and let him do it.
You can put that in my pants too.
Go ahead.
Just give it straight to him.
Just go ahead. Let him go ahead and do it.
Just cut out the middleman.
Go ahead and do it.
Just put it in his pocket.
Shout out to DC Young Fly. No days. Shout out to DC. He's always here. Navv's gonna accept the award one more time for him.
Shout out to DC.
Did this nigga go put on a hat like he won a championship?
Like he got drafted.
What the fuck, bro? This nigga just went on to put a hat like he just got drafted to the NBA.
Hey, man. Don't ever take no time.
No days off, huh? If anybody deserved that award, it would be DC Young Fly, and he couldn't be here because, of course, no days off, he's working. And speaking of no days off, when you think about what that means, you think about what you have to put in to actually say that and mean that. A lot of people say it, but a lot of people don't live that. And he's showing, and he's producing, and he's showing what no days off mean. On behalf of Karlous, Clayton English, Chico Bean, J-O-N, Ryan, Chad, Cat. As I say that, Chad walks through the door. And I don't want to make this about me, but I want to say this. Damn. 85 South is just not a network. It's just not an app. It's just not comedy. This shit is a family. It's brotherhood.
Put on white jeans for this.
T-Pain, you are mic'd up. And I just want to say this because y'all probably don't realize. Just look how many lives y'all done changed. Now I know we joke a lot. Well, bro, this shit like a family around here, man. The shit y'all say and y'all just instill in people make people want to do more and be more. No days off. Thank you, 85%.
Hey, man.
What can you say?
What can you say?
What can you say?
That Nev hasn't already said.
Yeah, Nev said it all.
You know he auditioning. This is a future Eddie Murphy movie.
Oh.
This nigga gonna send the tape. I just want to show my range.
Joe.
Don't send him no footage, Joe.
Eddie Murphy car, don't send none of that shit. None of that shit. He didn't say nothing. He didn't say no word up there. All them sentences, they ain't made no connection. They ain't say nothing.
Hey, man.
Damn.
To another year. Man, we done did this a whole nother year, man.
Another one. And after one of the most probably weirdest years motherfuckers have never had.
Yeah.
As far as, you know, just
shutting everything down. Bro, we run out of chicken wings and chicken tenders at this point.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all man. Mind if I steal this idea for my podcast or y'all good?
What are you talking about? Just the whole award thing. Can I come on that bitch?
You got a podcast? You ain't even tell us about it?
I'm trying to be on that bitch.
Wait a minute. You ain't even tell us about this shit.
He do got a podcast.
I know, I seen his podcast. You know what I mean?
What's it called?
I ain't watch it, but I seen it.
What is it called?
It's a Nappy Boy Radio podcast.
Yeah. See, that I thought it was radio. So,
I don't have enough chairs for y'all niggas. It's
That's what it is. We'll come one at a time.
We'll come individually.
We'll show up individually. Fuck you in.
Stagger. Tag each other in.
I mean, yeah. Okay, cool. All right. Put them on the books, please.
This nigga Nav is live.
Put us down. Right
now. Hey, get off the
Get off the fucking line, man. You on there with the trophy and shit.
Yeah, you know.
So you know. So T-Pain got a whole podcast.
Oh yeah,
go back. No, that was a quick. Just making sure. I am taking this whole thing. I'm stealing this for.
Bro, what do you mean? It was quick. You still? Your podcast gone?
Yeah. No, I'm taking the idea of the award shit.
We stole this from somebody else.
Oh, okay. No,
this is what you call evergreen material.
Anybody can do it. As long as you can do it.
Passing around somebody like
that. But where can they find your podcast? Where can they watch
it? Anywhere you watch podcasts at. We with podcasts once, so you know, YouTube, Apple Music, all the stuff that you're supposed to say when you're promoting yourself, but I'm terrible at that, so
let's watch the live stream.
Why is this about me now?
But you started it.
I was just saying, I'm gonna steal y'all idea. I didn't say I wanted to promote. Oh my goddamn.
What if all people want to see the shit?
I tweet this later, y'all. I'm just do this.
And we want to steal your shit.
Right.
I'm gonna take that freestyle you use on your live stream, the intro song. Boop, boop. That shit go hard.
That's the new intro.
Boop, boop. When you see me on this bitch talking about some boop, boop.
But Los want to come on Twitch. Los got to get on Twitch.
So you just, that's when you be on there playing like Call of Duty and all types
of
shit.
But I be making music on Twitch too, so.
That's where you let everybody have it.
That's perfect.
Exactly.
I
want to do a song with Top Hat T-Pain. So on Twitch, that's what I want to be my first appearance.
It don't take a lot to bring him back.
I'm going to come over there. You put the Top Hat on, make the beat. We make a song.
Boop, Molly, there we go. We back.
You can do that before I get there. I don't want to see you. Because if you take some white powder and put it on your tongue, I'm not assuming it's Molly. I'm going to think you're on powder. So I'm going to go ahead and let you do your powder or your Molly, whatever you call it. Your
Chico B, what you see? You saw something?
No, I ain't seen nothing.
Get your ass in that booth.
I got you. So we going to do that, man, but you know.
I don't know, man. T-Pain just reached in the top hat, pulled out of the Put it on his throat, and next thing you know, he made me a beat.
And the nigga had a rabbit in that motherfucker, too.
I can't wear headphones with the top hat, so when I'm recording this top hat, T-Pain, I gotta wear an orange cane bowl. So it's just...
I got one of them.
Just bring one of them.
Yeah, I got one. I got a
bring
orange
cane. Bring one of the ones that kind of ball up in the front, though.
I got an orange one, a yellow one.
We need to do a song, man. You got a song called Shoot the Club Up. You know what that's about.
I know what that's about. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And when you think about that, bro, that is really the worst place to shoot.
Cause I wonder
if you in a club and a nigga starts shooting, you got that you in the club and you gonna hit something. So I wonder
what I sound like in real auto.
I don't think you know the song. I don't think you know
like,
the song.
Not that shit.
Oh, I know what it's about. I know it's about shooting the other club up. No, but I'm just saying it's a great analogy because if you shoot in a real club, ooh. And then you shoot the wrong club.
They telling me I'm promoting violence and shit?
No.
People that don't know what the shit is.
You promote life.
You promote life, but when you think
that's
about it, it's life and violence because you shoot the wrong club. That shit can get violent.
That's pro life.
It's definitely all the way.
Oh my God. I don't know if we need to be around or something. Don't make this about me. Please keep the award there.
This is all about T-Pain.
I wouldn't.
This award show was sponsored in part by T-Pain and Nappy Boy Productions.
Absolutely.
Hey, you know how long I've been waiting to hear that, man.
Thank you.
Nappy Boy!
My favorite was Teddy Pinder Ass Down.
He kind of was sponsored. The amount of when I spent in gas to get here.
Nobody tell you to drive that fucking Lamborghini, nigga.
I'm just saying.
You drove your regular car.
I put it in sport to get on it, to get here in time. Now, see, what happened was I paid money for that. I kind of sponsored this. Also, being the only nigga that actually showed up and then having to get goddamn introduced by Navv Green, I think I'm somewhat qualified. You know what? Roll the credits and put me in the top. Put me at the top. I directed this shit.
We are using a picture of Top Hat.
You suffer from chopping the screw, but all the rest of the shit, I was out of shape.
Okay,
I'm still trying to figure out how to buy clothes.
Well, there you have it, folks.
Another one.
Ghetto Legends Award.
Now,
another break.
We got 2022 on the horizon,
And it's right around the corner, man.
It's right around the corner, man.
But it wouldn't be right if I didn't ask everybody what they leaving in 2021.
What am I leaving in 2021?
What you leaving?
Man, I'm leaving not having a Lamborghini.
Yeah, me too.
That's what I'm leaving in 2021. I got to get me one of them motherfuckers.
Look at this broke ass shit.
Man. I don't know if you want the problems that come with it.
I don't want the problems that come with it, but I want one. So if you don't want the problems that come with yours, I'll gladly take it.
We'll work out a payment plan.
I bet. That's what it is. I just come over and make a whole bunch of songs on Twitch. We gonna make one hit, bro, and that's gonna pay for the Lamborghini, nigga. I signed a big red.
Somebody gonna like one of them.
Deal for that.
Somebody gonna like one of them.
For sure.
Let me just take pictures with yours.
That's mostly what everybody does.
That's a Lamborghini.
Yeah.
I don't need a Lamborghini, I just need a Lamborghini. Let me come over there a couple times, get in front of that bitch, lean on it. Not a lot of pressure.
See, I'm gonna take it too far. I'm gonna be the nigga on top of that motherfucker like Pussy, man. Pussy ass nigga, you see me on top of that motherfucker.
All the way up. Mama, we did it. All kind of shit, nigga. All on top of the goddamn Lamborghini.
In all seriousness, though, man, any doubt, you know what I mean? That's something I've been working on this year is defeating doubt, you know what I mean? With the loss of my mother, man, it changed my whole perspective on all this shit. Fuck everything. Fuck what anybody think about you. Fuck what they say about you. Do what make you happy, because one day, you're out of here. And when you're out of here, you're out of here. So you gotta live for you while you're here and do what really make you happy, man. Fuck doubt. Fuck what people gonna say, what they gonna think, all that. Live your life for you, man.
Yeah.
How about you, Clayton? What are you leaving in 2021?
Hey, man, I'm going into 2022 being a part of the MCU, so that's all I do. And it's something that I call. So I'm adopting your thing of the doubt too. But I think what I'm leaving in 2021 is all that shit that don't motherfucking matter. All that shit to weigh you down that you was like, hey, this shit don't fucking matter. It's so much of this shit, because what's for you is for you. Everybody want to get to the bag, but your bag got your
got
luggage
your name
tag on it.
Yeah.
It's going to be there. So, yeah, just more manifesting. Not leaving nothing, but just keep doing it.
Right.
I did it without even knowing I'm doing it.
Right.
So that's what I always tell people. If you just check your thoughts, at least half the time, you're going to get at least half the results. And that's better than the zero you was fucking getting.
For sure.
Yeah.
That's that.
Los.
Oh, in 2022, I'm being like Maxine Waters. I'm reclaiming all my time. Let's go. All my time. I'm not doing no long talking. I'm not explaining shit. I'm moving at the beat of my own drum. And if you ain't fucking with it, fuck you.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. We gotta get back to the basics, man.
Yeah, all the
people
way.
Have, that's you know, like if you give so much of yourself, people start taking too much. Like, man, I gotta take my time back, you know what I'm saying? And it ain't like I'm having to cut nobody off. I just understand, like you said though, time is of the essence and it's a luxury.
Yeah.
So if I gotta be giving it out, it gotta be to the shit I wanna give it to.
Right, there it is. That's
it. That's it. Thank you.
Keep hanging.
I just so happen to still be here. I didn't think this was gonna fall on me. I
want to. Come on, man. It's your turn. You are here now. It's over.
Being oblivious. I think that's what I'm leaving. Knowing that I am my own person. Knowing that being rich is measured in money and being wealthy is measured in time. Knowing that, you know, I got signed when I was 17. And from that day, I've always been told that I needed to check in with other people before I do anything. And, you know, it didn't dawn on me till 2-3 years ago that I could make decisions on my own with my own shit. And that's really when I started being not only the happiest person I've ever been, but quite frankly, the most wealthy I've ever been. You know what I'm saying? The most in control I've ever been, you know, not waking up thinking I gotta call somebody to see if I can do this for my homeboy. I gotta call somebody to see if I can make this move or whatnot. Or before I put out this song, I gotta call somebody and make sure it's all right. And that it's just, I wake up and I do the things I wanna do because when everything goes to shit, them people that I had to check in with, they're not gonna be there regardless. So why not go ahead and fucking figure out how to do my own shit. You know, people always ask me, you ain't got nobody to do this for you. T-Pain, what the fuck are you doing in Target? I didn't see none of this shit outside, so I figured I'd come in and but it's like, you know, people feel like when you get up to a certain level, you stop doing things for yourself. I know how to iron my fucking clothes. I don't need a person to iron my clothes. I know how to goddamn tie my shoes on. I got it. Like, even when my stylist come and try to, like, tie my shoes, I'm like, calm down. Let me do this, because everything is going to come to an end at some point. And when it's over with, I need to know how to do this shit, and I need to know how to fucking run myself for myself.
There you go.
And that the idea that I can't do that is what I'm leaving behind in 2021.
Hell yeah. Tying their own shoes in 2022, nigga.
I'm gonna take that off my list. I know that's right? When you made it.
Yeah, when you just stop tying your own shoes.
Coming to America shit. The shoes are not going to tie themselves.
All right. It's only right. Nav.
Nav.
Go ahead, Nav.
Get back to the podium, please. Yeah, damn.
And tell us more about who you're wearing.
Don't do that. Just...
This is from the Teddy Ruxpin collection.
Actually, since you inquired, this is also from the Michael Strahan collection. Only people with gaps can shop there.
I knew that's where you got that shit from. I told you that turtleneck,
the name, the gap is already taken.
It's already taken. I told you that turtleneck ain't regulation size. You got to stop shopping in tall nigga shops.
That nigga turtleneck. Yeah, I just realized that. That nigga turtleneck behind his ears. God damn, that nigga got
him. He pull up the
phone. Like y'all was asking me.
Really a hoodie. That nigga didn't tuck the hoodie in. You pulled the back of that bitch out of hoodie in that motherfucker. Oh, my bad. Oh, yeah.
You pull up the folding part and turn into a ski mask.
I bet this will be the last time I come dressed to show you niggas some respect.
And he gotta keep spitting his goddamn turtleneck out of his mouth.
I just wanted to leave behind all the people who got negative comments about me. I'm leaving that shit in 2021. Anybody who don't see the... A lot of people, they always want to talk about the bad. You know, they don't never mention the good. Yeah, I made one fuck up. And that's what a person keep on remembering week after week every time they see me. But they don't remember the times I call and say, hey, I'm not gonna say no name, but hey, Los, you one of the funniest niggas I know. And he replied, bruh, I ain't gonna lie, I needed that at the time. But now I'm just such a bad motherfucking nigga that you portray me to be. And I just wanna leave that in 2021. Thank y'all for tuning in.
Hey man, 85 South Show, we out this bitch. 85, let's go.
Oh, shit. Oh, man.
Now, go, jump in the picture, man. Jump in the picture, man.
Come on, man.
I gotta stand back up.
That shit was funny.